Hello everyone, I'm Dylan. We just stopped Gold from going down to Deponia, so let's find out what happens.
Who the devil are you?
Your future, but you can call me Rufus.
Huh. Well, a fine future awaits me then. You nearly blew up Elysium.
Not much better than what Elysians have in mind for Deponia.
Yeah.
You're Deponian? Then it's true. There is life on Deponia.
Which makes your inspection tour obsolete.
Quite the opposite. Deponia is inhabited. I've just got to see it.
Why?
You're already talking to the creme de la creme. The rest is... Yep, exactly. Like him.
Another Deponian.
Seen enough?
I think so.
We don't have a lot of time to enjoy eternity. Or to break this vicious circle. I mean, nothing is getting broken around here. I'm on Elysium with Gol. It can stay this way forever.
What are you talking about?
We have got into a time loop.
Mm-hmm.
We don't do anything. This thing will repeat itself for all eternity.
Which works for me.
Doesn't necessarily have to be a bad thing.
Wow, that sounds exciting. What can we do?
Fun zone?
No. Deponia. There's my chrono car.
Where?
That's the source of the anomaly.
A real adventure. Do I still have time to get my detective set?
Are you crazy? We're not going anywhere.
What's happening?
Oh no, the high boat.
Right, that's settled.
But
and they lived happily ever after. Without ever coming even close to anything resembling the end of time.
What's happening with you?
This is the first and probably last day of your life.
Am I meant to be pleased about that?
Yes, but please don't take too long. There are only 24 hours in a day. The clock is ticking.
Okay.
Cole now has the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to get to know me again. Or for the whatever-ith time.
Alright.
Bravo! That was probably our last chance of getting to Deponia.
I thought you didn't want to interfere with the course of events.
Yeah.
But how can you speak of the course of events when things are not actually moving right now?
Maybe not for you.
I have monster slippers.
Wait a minute. Did you nick that from our habitat?
Yes, we share everything.
Since when?
Since 6 weeks from Monday.
Well, you put it back until then, okay?
Okay.
In the last loop. They shouldn't be here.
Holy moly! We're gonna be killed by fuel locks for eternity.
Not if I will have been able to prevent it.
Alright. Fuel locks!
Good?
Punch them! Bite them! Kick them! Well, they're not attacking, so that's good. The button.
What are you doing? Are you trying to kill us?
No, I wanted to leave that to the fuel locks.
Come on, shut that door. I'm scared of heights.
Is it greater than your fear of being torn apart by fuel locks?
Well, yeah. It's great enough for me to always carry a parachute in my backpack.
What?
Did I say parachute? Pair of shoes. Or a parachute. I don't even think of it.
Jump.
Now, hold on.
No, wait.
We landed!
Rufus, are you all right?
Hello?
Nothing is all right. You and I, we once saved Deponia. Now, damn time machine. I thought we could make everything turn out even better without my having to plunge to my death in the end. But now, everything is worse. And the best I can hope for is to restore the old version. Elysium will fall, you'll hate me, or the Fulox will rule the planet.
Sounds like we've been through a lot together.
Oh yeah, you could say that.
Sure.
Then I've got good news for you. In this timeline, I don't hate you yet. Quite the opposite, actually. I'm finding this all very exciting. Time travel, fuel locks, parachutes, and the day has only just begun. If I think of everything that could happen tomorrow as well...
But first there has to be a tomorrow.
That sounds like an adventure.
Then wash your ears. We don't even know where we landed here. How are we supposed to make it to Kuvak by this evening?
Just look at my chronicle. He would never give up.
Where is he?
Say what? But that's...
I help you.
If there's one thing I never do, then it is... Give up. Who cares if Elysium is now infested with Fulox? Or that we changed everything that was saving Deponia from demolition? The main thing is, I'm still alive. Nothing else matters. I wanted to go to Elysium? Check. I wanted to save the world? Check. Okay, it's been more saved. I admit it. But no one wants me to go through all that crap again. All I have to do is break this stupid time loop. Look to the future. That's the motto.
That's the right attitude, I think.
Yeah.
So, which way to Kuvat?
Alrighty then. We're in a weird dystopian. Is that guy wearing nothing? Is he naked? The Prophet.
Ah, there you are. It doesn't work.
What doesn't work?
I thought so.
Well, I would know if we had. I can even remember things that haven't happened yet.
Then maybe it does work.
What works?
The prophesying. I foresee things.
Okay.
Well, welcome to the club.
And I speak with our maker.
Please leave. Spider-Man?
Don't worry. At the moment, I don't do either. Chiseler's block. I'm stuck on the 4¾ commandment.
4¾?
Yes. The third one ended up being quite long.
Who cares?
Well, space on the stone is limited. And then there are the high localization costs.
And still,
originally, it was just going to be 3 commandments.
Blessing in disguise. You ran into just the right man.
Thou shalt never carve things in stone.
Okay, how about thou shalt never carve things in stone?
Ooh, I like that. It's succinct, and it has that self-identity that we usually find in the title of hip-hop records.
Wait, are you serious? Is that the right one?
Like someone who sleeps under a bridge, but then where did he get the curtains? Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm welcome to Hobo Moses.
Thou shalt not write things in stone.
Yeah, that's a good one. The perfect conclusion for the series. I think you should do another one.
Don't you think it leaves too many questions open?
Right. For example, what happened to those neighbors? They appeared in the second commandment, were never mentioned again.
Alright.
Maybe you shouldn't have carved it in stone. Now you need another commandment to reconcile you with your community.
Alright.
Need any...
No. I want to finish the tap.
And as your producer...
I hit you in the head.
Everything's broken. As far as the eye can see.
Yeah, welcome to my world.
Okie dokie.
Do you know the way to Kuvak?
Who, what?
Kuvak, a village south of Busa Westfar.
Yeah.
That doesn't really sound like the hub of existence.
Nah, it's more like the hub of hopelessness.
Whatever. At least 4 days march to Busa.
4 days?
It would even take a whole day in a rust bucket.
I don't have an entire day.
Then forget it. There's nothing here.
But the robot.
Port of Rustica is a few hours upriver. If someone gave you a lift, you might just make it.
Before my chronicle leaves for Kuvak. Of course. Did you hear that, Goal? There's still hope. Now we just need to find my chronicle.
And someone will lend you hope. Maybe you can find one at the fair.
At the what?
The fair? I'm getting all the right answers!
I think I just found my chronicle.
Is he trapped on that? Is he trapped on the roller coaster? Back to the robot.
Hey there.
Are you
What do you do around here? Who are you?
We are legionaries.
We fought in the colonial wars in Haldika.
Okay.
Now we're just lost souls swimming in the fishbowl without any purpose to our lives.
Same.
Think of one. A little tip. Monkeys do it to get rid of their lice. I think it's time for me to leave. Otherwise, I'm likely to get bored of Midas.
Do what you have to do.
We'll find out what we can do in the next episode. As always, thank you for watching. And I will see you eventually.